If you've ever modded the older GTA games before, you've probably run into an issue like this, especially when installing higher quality textures. This issue appears when the game hasn't got enough memory for streaming in the game world, which causes LOD models to appear instead of the higher quality models it's meant to show close to the player. This is usually solved by installing some sort of mod that increases the memory the game can use for streaming. Usually, limit adjusters can do this, such as Open Limit Adjuster, but there's plenty of options out there that allow you to tweak the game's streaming memory limit. So while it seems simple, a lot of people don't actually seem to understand how streaming memory works and what the best limit is, so let's go over it in this video. I'll be using San Andreas in this video as an example, but this applies to GTA 3 and Vice City as well. The older GTA games are 32-bit applications, which means by default, they can only use 2GB of system memory, also known as RAM. So out of that 2GB, they can only use a certain amount of that RAM for streaming. Streaming is basically the loading in and out of things in the game world, such as vehicles, pedestrians, map models, map textures, etc. It's faster doing it this way. Instead of the game constantly having to load individual files directly from your HDD or SSD, the game will instead load them into RAM, which allows them to be quickly loaded when they're needed. By default, San Andreas only allows a maximum of 64 megabytes of RAM to be used for streaming, which is very little when modding, considering some mods like Rosa have texture archives that can be around 28 megabytes in size, which is nearly half of your streaming memory budget gone from just one texture archive. Using mods like Open Limit Adjuster, we can adjust how much memory the games can use for streaming. So for example, we can change the amount of RAM the game can use for streaming to 500 megabytes. When you force launch a new game while using a heavy texture mod like Rosa, along with a few other mods, the game could already be using around 350 megabytes out of that 500 megabytes, just for streaming. As you play the game and stream more things in and out of the game world, the streaming memory usage will continue to increase until it reaches the 500 megabyte limit that you've set. It won't go down until it reaches the limit. Once the 500 megabyte limit has been reached, only then will the game start to unload files out of RAM and load new files into RAM. Once you reach the 500 megabyte limit you've set for streaming, the game will continue to hover around that limit until you restart the game. This can actually cause some stutters on slower systems. The San Andreas mod Improved Streaming has several options to help alleviate this. I'll leave a link to it in the description. Keep in mind, the game will be using RAM for other tasks too. If you look at Task Manager, you'll see the game will be using even more RAM. This will be the RAM used for streaming, and also the RAM the game is using for other tasks, the same as any other application. The maximum amount of RAM you can set the game to use for streaming memory is 2GB. However, like I said before, these games are 32-bit applications, so they can only use 2GB of RAM in total. If you set the limit for streaming memory to 2GB, the game won't have enough RAM for other tasks. This will cause issues as you play, such as pause menu textures not loading and other things in the game not working correctly. Eventually, the game will crash once these issues start to appear. However, there is a patch that can increase the amount of RAM these games can use, called LargeAddress. This basically enables a flag called LargeAddressAware in the game's executable. This flag allows 32-bit applications to use more RAM. On 64-bit systems, this will allow a 32-bit application to use 4GB of RAM. On 32-bit systems, this will allow a 32-bit application to use 3GB of RAM. Although, you will need to enable the 3GB switch on your Windows installation if you're on a 32-bit version of Windows. I'll leave a link in the description below on how to do that. I'd always recommend using LargeAddress. I'll leave a link to it in the description. So if you have LargeAddress installed, the game can now use more RAM. I have a 64-bit system, so with LargeAddress, my game can now use 4GB of RAM. Even though my game can now use 4GB of RAM, the maximum I can allocate for streaming is still 2 GB. However, setting the streaming memory limit to 2 GB will no longer cause issues, as the game can use the other 2 GB of RAM for other tasks. 2 GB is beyond what you'd ever need for these games. So what would I recommend you set your streaming memory limit to? It really depends on your situation, but this is what I generally go with. Install LargeAddress so your game can now use more RAM. If you have 8 GB of RAM, set the streaming memory limit to 1 GB. I personally use Open Limit Adjuster to adjust the limit, as it supports GTA 3 and Vice City as well. However, you can change the limit with another mod if you like, such as Fastman 92 Limit Adjuster or Mix Sets. If you have less than 8 GB of RAM, set the streaming limit to 500 MB. This is so your system itself will have enough RAM for other tasks. If you're running into issues such as seeing low quality models or textures up close, this generally means you need to increase the limit gradually until the issue is solved. If you're running into issues such as pause menu textures not loading and then the game crashing right after, generally this means the game hasn't got enough RAM for other necessary tasks, so decrease the streaming memory limit until the issue is solved. These issues won't always be because of the streaming memory limit, but generally this is what will cause these issues. For San Andreas specifically, I'd also recommend installing the mod Improved Streaming. This mod can reduce stutters and optimizes the RAM usage of San Andreas overall. And that's it for this video. Videos have been quite slow recently, however, I've been busy working on a new modding guide for San Andreas, which will hopefully be finished in the next month or two. I made a community post on the channel last month about what to expect in the guide and what's next for the channel, so be sure to check it out if you're curious. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more content like this.